everyone, it's Rev Deb and Miracles One here with you for Living the Lessons podcast. And today is lesson 135. If I defend myself, I am attacked. Indeed, nice lesson today, folks. Defense is frightening, but we do it, right? We think we're being attacked, and that's why we defend ourselves. We're defending the body, but we're attacking the mind. And that's what we need to remember here as we practice this lesson. So, if I defend myself, I am attacked. 15 minutes twice today. We got to do this now. If I defend myself, I am attacked. But in defenselessness, I will be strong and I will learn what my defenses hide. Let me share my thoughts with you. So this lesson today can seem hard to understand. After all, we do live here in the world and we are told that attacks are imminent on all fronts. It can seem hard to believe that we are safe in God, yet Jesus speaks the truth, and we are pretty attached to our bodies and the world. Heck, I'm talking to you through this means, and you are listening. I was thinking about an experience recently from a few years ago as someone shared with me a similar experience that they just had. And so this day, I recall the rain was just pouring down. I had gone to the grocery store to pick up needed items for our grandson's weekend visit. As I was leaving the store, I proceeded to enter my van, drive forward. As I was waiting my turn to leave the parking lot to the street, a man was walking very briskly toward me. I felt threatened and immediately realized my van's auto lock had not triggered as yet. So I triggered the lock and shouted, "No," as he came up to the window. Finally, other cars had moved out of the lot, and I pulled out quickly. I was nervous and breathing heavily. I quickly asked the Holy Spirit's assistance in seeing this man differently. How did I know what this man wanted? I quickly reviewed where I was parked in comparison to where I ran, so to speak, into him. No, it couldn't be. I left something in the cart. What if I left my wallet or my card? No, I'm not sure I have. Holy Spirit. Well, I can still protect myself and still see this individual as God sees him. It doesn't mean I failed. It is all really about our mind and how we are quick to defend the mind and our choices. The body will do here in the world what it will do, and so will other bodies. It is my perception that matters. In truth, my brother was innocent. I have no idea why at that time he was approaching my van, but lots of stories sure came to mind. I made a plan for my safety, and as I said, there's nothing wrong with that at all. God would never offer pain to our mind. The defenses we put up in our mind do let us see God's love and his see God's love and his blessings. Yet we do think we are slave to this body, and that is what the unhealed mind believes. The truth is, we are not our bodies, we are spirit. Yet this can be confusing to us as students. Does this mean I let people do whatever they want to me? Well, no, it doesn't mean that. We listen to our inner guidance system. Even though I was in fear, I listened and I can learn from it. I can learn to see beyond my brother to the light within, whether his intentions were honorable or not. We are all God's children regardless. I cannot leave him outside heaven. Here in the world, I may have to guard myself. I have nothing to prove and all to learn if I am open. So remember our lesson website at acimlessons.org and our main website at miraclesone.org. So thank you so much for listening with me today. And as always, I wish you much peace. Namaste.